Hello, my name is Van Nguyen. I'm the project lead. This is Julian Barata. He's responsible for programming the mobile application. This is Umar Chalons and Johnny Vu. They're responsible for general assistance with assembly and programming. The project we are presenting revolves around the issue of child death due to vehicular heat stroke. Of the 700 deaths that have occurred since 1998, 54% of them were due to a parent or caregiver simply forgetting a child in a car. Our goal was to develop a car seat alarm system that is able to detect a child left in a car and then alert the appropriate contacts that there is a situation, thus preventing future deaths. In order to implement the system, we had to solve two problems. We needed to detect the child, and then we needed to be able to communicate with the parent and caregivers. We solved these problems by integrating several key components. Firstly, the system was powered by a rechargeable battery so that when the car is turned off, the system is able to continue running. Secondly, in order to detect the child, a pressure pad sensor and a clip sensor were used. The clip sensor works by using a Hall effect sensor and a magnet, and the pressure pad sensor is simply an array of force-sensitive resistors. Additionally, other sensors such as temperature were also used. In this case, as the temperature increases in the vehicle, the system will adjust and send out the alerts sooner and sometimes even immediately if the temperature is Third, in order to contact the caregiver or even the police, the system utilizes cellular service to send text MMS messages alerting the appropriate contacts. Additionally, GPS is used to send location data, and Bluetooth is also utilized to create a user interface through a mobile phone application. And finally, a microprocessor such as an Arduino is used to read the sensors and control the system. As far as measuring our performance, we wanted to focus on how often the hardware and software perform their intended role, as well as how often the system is able to detect a child. These performance metrics are important to us because we wish to create a system that is much more reliable than other car seat products already available in the market. And in the latest trial, we were able to get our car seat alarm was able to detect a child and alert the appropriate contacts at least 95% of the time, hitting our performance goals. And if anyone has any questions.
95%?
At least 90%. So the purpose of our system has two purposes. Detect a child, and if the child is still in the vehicle when the car is turned off, it'll start sending out alerts via text message. And so long as it detects the child and then sends out that text message, we consider it successful as long as everything else goes all right.
Why most of the time did it not detect the child?
I mentioned 95%. I said at least 95%. In our latest trial, it worked 20 out of 20 times.
20 out of 20? Mm-hmm. So 95% is not right.
It's at least 95%.
You said 20 out of 20, I mean 100% that worked.
Yes, but I said at least 95% of the time.
We're getting 95% wrong.
That was our goal, right?
Oh, that
was our goal, basically, to reach at least 95% of the time.
Okay.
So I turn my car off and then go to the back seat and get the baby out. Am I going to get a bunch of text messages?
If you can do it fast enough, assuming you don't take 30 minutes to take the child out, yes, it'll stop.
Okay.
We have this sort of increment system where after it would first send out a beep just to remind you that you have a child. And then after, say, about 5 minutes, if I recall correctly, then it would send out the first wave of text to the driver. And then after that, it would send it to another one. And then finally, it would, maybe 10 or 15 minutes, it would send the text to the driver to secondary contact and finally to the police.
Okay.
So is there a feedback mechanism? So if I get the first message and I say, acknowledge it, and say, I'll take care of it, then you don't send subsequent messages?
At the moment, feedback as far as text message, there is no feedback through that. But the option is there, and if that is something we want to explore, we could have done that. At the moment, you physically have to go to the box and either take the child out or just shut it off.
Hmm.
Okay. Is there any standard about the LDC that you have to follow or
Actually, our little car seat alarm doesn't actually integrate complete with the car seat. It's designed so that you can take it and use it with any car seat, and it should not affect the safety of the car seat at all.
Okay, I don't know, but I surmise there are standards, there are laws about this baby seat that one should follow. Are you aware of that? Did you consider that?
Yes, I'm aware that they need to meet standards, but the idea is that the car seat and the certified car seat will be able to handle, say, in case of a car crash, it'll be able to handle the safety. And the our car seat alarm is just secondary. It should not impact safety.
Because I think you put sensor inside the seat, and this probably changes the safety of the seat.
Well, the only two things we changed to the seat is putting a little pressure pad, which is made out of felt and various sensors underneath the seat. And then we also put a little clip that can be attached to the seat belt in addition to the clip that's already there.
This could only be a safety hazard. I mean, the child could swallow the pin or something.
There really aren't any small pieces. Everything else is either too large for a child to swallow or should, you know, not break.
How do you structure your messages?
It's a rather simple message. It basically says that a child is stuck in the car, and it sends you the longitude, latitude, and then also temperature in addition.
Is 911 set up to receive that?
Excuse me?
You send that to 911, you text 911.
We don't actually text it to 911, but interestingly enough, more and more call centers are actually having the option to send text message, which I believe should happen nationwide eventually, as text message has the usefulness of requiring you not to talk to a phone in certain situations. And if we really wanted to push out a product, we could send text message in the Dallas area.
How do you do set up on the device? How do you talk to it so you can set up your phone number to this kind of text?
So the phone application is set up that once you download it, you simply pair through Bluetooth to the system, and then you can, through the app, enter your first number and second number.
How do you determine, you said when the car is stopped is when this gets activated?
It's not when it's stopped, it's when the car's turned off. So when this car seat alarm is connected to the car, through the cigarette lighter, so when power is no longer supplied, the system goes, hey, the car is off.
Okay, how easy is it to turn this thing off? If I'm sitting at Sonic or I'm on a ferry and I'm just going to be sitting there for a while, how easy can I get to it?
Actually, just a little button you can push on the side. If you hold it for 2 seconds, it'll shut off.
Does the pressure sensor, is that basically the child sits on it, or the pressure sensor, the car seat sits on the sensor?
The child sits on it.
Yeah.
So you would
place. Do you have the car battery voltage is going to that sensor underneath the child, or is that the lower voltage?
It's 5 volts.
What kind of batteries do you use to power it?
We just use 3.7 volt small little lithium ion batteries.
Any more questions?
How much did it cost you to build this machine?
At the moment, probably about 150 or so. Some of the parts we used, we could have used cheaper parts, but we used the more expensive ones. And now that we've already completed the project, we know we can use the cheaper parts.
Okay. All right. Let's thank the team.